Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are safe and keeping well. Today, we will continue with our lesson, Transport and Communication. Children, in the previous class, we have learned about what is the meaning of transport, what are the different means of transport. We have learned about land transport, water transport, and air transport. And today, we are going to learn about communication. We will learn what does the word communicate mean and the different means of communication. So children, what does the word communicate mean? The word communicate means to transmit or pass messages to each other. And anything that we use to send messages or to receive messages are called means of communication. For example, we have telephone, we have emails, we have letters. All these are means of communication. Okay, they help us to communicate to other persons. They help us to send messages to other persons, and through these means we receive messages. Now, communication is divided into two main categories. We have two main categories of communication. Number one, we have personal communication, and we have mass communication. Now let us learn about personal communication. Children, personal communication is a means of communication which is used to transfer messages between two people. Okay, between two individuals, when you want to transfer a message, when you want to send or receive a message, we use personal communication. For example, we have mobile phones. Yes, we have telephones. Okay, and we also have postal service. Now, what is postal service, children? A very simple word I'll give you, letters. The first thing we should have in our mind when we are speaking about postal service is letters. Children, in olden days, we did not have telephones. We didn't have telephones. We didn't have mobile phones. So, people used letters to communicate to their families, their friends, and other people. Okay? So, what did they do? They used to write letters. They used to put it in the post box. The postman used to take all these letters, take it to the post office. There they put the stamp and everything. And from there, they will give it to different postmen. And they will travel to those places and give the letters to the following persons. Okay. Now, we have different types of letters. Number one is a postcard. Now, children, the postcard is the cheapest means of postal service communication. Okay, here's a picture of a postcard, children. Look here. Children, it is a yellow color card. Okay, on the right side, you'll be seeing that there are some lines drawn. Okay, there you will be writing the receiver's address. Okay, whoever is going to receive this letter, to whomever you are going to send this letter, you will write its address on the right side. And below that, you will write the PIN code. Now, what is the PIN code, children? PIN code is a special number which is assigned to every post office. Okay, every post office has a PIN code. It's a code. It's a number code which is used by all the post offices to deliver letters. Okay, so this is a postcard, children. Okay, it is very cheap and you can get it from the post office. Now let us move to the next type of postal service. We have inland letters. Okay, this is a picture of inland letter. Okay, now see, children, the inland letter is also divided into two parts. Now see, children, on one side where there is the picture of Mahatma Gandhi. Can you see the picture of Mahatma Gandhi? Yes. There you write the receiver's address. okay, to whomever you want to send the letter, you will write its address on the side where there is the picture of Mahatma Gandhi. Then afterwards, there is another side where there are two lines drawn. Okay, you can see it in the picture here. Yes, okay, in that place you will write your address. Okay, now children, inland letters are also very easy, but they are little bit expensive than the postcards. Okay, it is comparatively expensive, it is costly than the postcards. Okay, these are the two means of postal service, okay, which you use to deliver messages. Children, in postal service, you can also send money. If you want to send money to your friends or anybody, to your family members, you can do so through the means of money order. You can also send small and urgent messages through telegram. Okay, so these are some of the postal service or the means of personal communication which we have learnt about. We have learnt about postcard, we have learnt about inland letters, and we have learnt about money order and telegram. Okay, I'll again explain. Postcards is used to deliver messages. Okay, it is the cheapest means of postal service. Then we have inland letters. Okay, inland letters is used to deliver messages. It is little bit expensive than the postcards. Okay, then we can send money to other persons through money order, and we can also send very short and urgent messages, okay, through telegram. Okay, if you want to send an urgent message, you know, and then that message should reach within hours to the another person, we can write as telegram. Okay, now the next type of personal communication is telephone. Okay, you can see here there are a picture of two types of telephones. Number one, we have the landline. Okay, this is a landline phone, children. The first picture is of a landline, and the second, you all know, it's a smartphone. Okay, now these two means of personal communication are used to deliver messages. Okay, through these means of communication, we can speak to the other person, okay, to people who are very far away from us. Okay, it is the most easiest and it is the most fastest ways of communication. It is the fastest means of communication. Okay, you can see it very well. Today we all are using mobile phones. Okay, within just one click, we can call the other person and we can speak to them. Even through the means of internet, we can send messages to our friends and family members. Okay, so these are the personal means of communication. We have postal service and we have telephone. Okay, children, I hope you all have understood. Now let us move to the next part, that is mass communication. Now what is mass communication, children? Children, you must have seen, you must have heard about newspapers, radios, televisions, internets and computer. What are these, children? Children, these are the means of communication which help us to communicate with a larger number of people at the same time. Okay, suppose you, just for example, if you have heard, whenever we have to tell some lockdown guidelines, your parents switch on the news channel, okay, in your television. Okay, and there our Prime Minister is delivering a message to all the people. So he is communicating with a large number of people at the same time through television. This television is a means of mass communication. Okay, so what do we mean by mass communication? Means of mass communication is used to communicate with a large number of people at the same time. Okay, these are all our means of mass communication. You can see here in the picture we have newspapers. Okay, children, newspapers are used टू डिलीवर इंफॉर्मेशन. दे गिव अस इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट वॉट इज हैपनिंग अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. ओके, वॉट आर द मेजर इंसिडेंट्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो द केसेस दैट आर इंक्रीजिंग, द कोविड केसेस विच आर इंक्रीजिंग, द वेदर, ओके, हाउ आर डिफरेंट कंट्रीज वर्किंग ड्यूरिंग दिस कोविड एरिया. ओके, ऑल दिस इंफॉर्मेशन वी गेट थ्रू न्यूज पेपर्स. देन वी हैव द रेडियो. Now children, in the olden days there were no television, so the means of entertainment was and means of entertainment and information was the radio. Okay, people used to listen to the radio. They used to have many entertaining channels. Okay, they used to have many entertaining programs, and they also tell us about different information. Okay, so this is the picture of a radio. Then the third one is television. Television gives us a large range of information, and also it is used as a means of entertainment. Okay, and then we have computer and the internet. Okay, now internet has become the major means of entertainment. We have YouTube, we have social media. All these are the means of communication through internet. Okay, it is because of internet we are able to communicate to different people living in far places. We can watch YouTube videos, we can gather information. So all these are means of mass communication. Okay children, so this is what we have learnt in today's chapter. I hope you have understood it well. Okay, so children, please take care, go through the video. Okay, tomorrow I will be giving you the study material of this chapter. Please go through it and learn it very well, as this will help in giving us, it will help us in doing our worksheets. Okay, so goodbye children, and take care.